With the MetaEdit Plus multi-user version, several users can work on the same set of models without ever locking each other out or having to merge each other's changes. We're going to look now at how that works when you also want to use a version control system. Let's say Git in this example. First of all, a shout out to Philip Langer and the folks at EclipseSource for making a great video of how to do similar things with eGit and EMF compare. I'll put the link in the notes below so you can have a look at that if you want to compare and contrast. We've got two MetaEdit Plus instances open here. Obviously, normally they'd be on two different computers, but for the purposes of the video then, all on one computer. They have no communication other than via the MetaEdit Plus multi-user server. On the left then we have the system administrator, the first user, and on the right a normal user who we're calling user 2, and we've made the background of his Windows green to help you keep track a bit more easily. If we try and log in at the moment, then we'll see it tells us the server isn't running yet. So let's start that up from here. Start it, accept the default port, and now we're ready to go. So the system administrator can log in first, our first user, and let's log in as user as well in the other instance. So they're both looking at the same state of the repository now. We have a model here called car in UML, the same example as in Philip Langer's video. So a car has wheels and an engine, and that engine can also be a diesel engine. Let's add a new electric engine as our first change by user 1, and let's make that inherit from engine. Okay, that'll do for our changes for now. If we look in the changes and versions tool in MetaEdit Plus, we can see it's spotted that there's been a change made. We can give a version number and write a version comment to say what was changed. We added electric engine and then save the version. And that saves it in the MetaEdit Plus multi-user repository. And with the VCS integration, then it's also calling Git to commit locally and to push to a remote shared Git. Now the second user wants to make a different change. At the moment, he doesn't see that first person's change because he started his transaction earlier, so he sees the earlier state. But he wants to make it possible for a car to have either one or two engines. So he makes his change, and he can go to the Changes and Versions tool, give a version number and a version comment, allow two engines and save the version. And again, that then is pushed to the multi-user repository, to the local Git and to the remote Git. So back at the first user, what does he see at the moment? He'll see his own changes, but he won't see the other user's changes because he hasn't committed yet. Let's say he wants to make a change to multiplicity 2. So in conflict with the previous user, he wants to say any number of engines, one or more. Look, the OK button's grayed out. He can't make that change because that property, the multiplicity property, is locked. It says there it's dirty locked, which means someone else has locked it and then committed their transaction. They've freed the lock, but because we've not seen their change yet, then we're not allowed to change that. We ought to see what they'd done first before we go in and change it too. So to see what they've done, all we need to do is commit our transaction. And now we can see their change. Okay, they'd said 1 to 2. We want 1 to star, so that's fine. We can make our change and go ahead and commit that. We can see also in the version history list, we can see all the other users' changes if we wanted to look at them in more detail. So now allow any number of engines, we've saved that version. And now all of those changes that we've made are merged together. Without any explicit merge operations, they're all there in the same repository. We can look at a textual diff of the changes, or look, say, to highlight that change that we made in this version. Or we could go back to an earlier version. Here's the version from the other user. Here's our version from earlier on, where we added the electric engine and its inheritance relationship. So it's that easy in MetaEdit Plus for multiple users to work together and to have their work versioned into your normal version control system. There's no explicit diffing. You don't have to pull, push, commit, merge, check out. You just work. When you've done some work, you save your version. The tool will take care of all the hard work behind the scenes, and you can concentrate on modeling and just saving your versions when you're ready. Thanks for watching. Have fun with MetaEdit Plus.